For today's video is ready na may maadto sa
Mangantukan.
Okay, today is the day nga mupaso na si Bobby Chow.
Yung bebe.
Char. For the first time and for the last time ko, no. So, sa ilahan ng busy days, oh, nanaon, nagbuhat ko banner, guys. Para sa akin, for the supportive girlfriend ta for today's video. So, nara ko mga kauban. For the ready go na ako mga igagaw. So, see you guys! See you there, mga kapamilya, mga ka... See ya!
So, Torres, you know?
Naglipo ko kung siya si Ken or siya si Barbie.
Sa
kagwapo ko.
Thank you.
Uniform attire. Yes, do you believe that our candidates wearing their completely uniform? It is a look fabulous and professional.
Prior the vulnerable ones that need, that deal with suicidal thoughts. We, the students of BBCC, are committed in providing equal opportunities for students that is dealing with complexities. And I believe that education is the key of success, and because of us, they will succeed in their daily life basis. That would be all and I. Thank you!
Thank you so much, Bilibili number one. And moving on, Bilibili number two. Please pick a number.
So your judge will be judge number four.
Okay, here's your question. As an ECE specialist, where diversities are commonly observed, how did you apply what you have acquired as you go along in this project?
Thank you. Diversity in a team is crucial, especially in ECE education. My role is to create an inclusive and productive environment where everyone's voice is heard. Together, we can collaborate that diversity is our strength and unity is our foundation to success. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you so much, Bilibili number two.
Please step forward, candidate number one. Please beat your lucky judge, ma'am. Okay, your judge would be judge number one.
Good evening, candidate number one.
Good evening, sir.
How are you?
Well, I'm feeling great, sir.
Okay, so here is your question. One of the visions of BBCC is to produce globally competitive individuals. If you will be given a chance to bear the crown of Mr. BZ tonight, how are you going to encourage the entire students that speaking using the universal language is essential?
Thank you for that wonderful question, sir. Being a PBCCian, one of our vision is to one of our mission is to promote holistically skilled and a globally competitive individuals. If I am going to crown as Mr. Bizet tonight, I will encourage the students to give importance to their academics, because as a globally competitive individuals, it is so important to focus on our academics, not only in our academics, but also in our characteristics. Because I do believe that education, being a globally competitive individual, is not just about enforcing rules, but it's also about guiding the students to promote or to produce a strong character and a moral compass. Thank you.
Candidate number one.
And now let us proceed for the candidate number two. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, ma'am.
Okay, what team are you representing? What team are you representing?
Purple team.
Yes, we're on the purple team! Yes, and now let us proceed for the Q&A portion, ma'am. Please speak your judge. Okay, your lucky judge would be judge number two.
Good evening, candidate number two.
Good evening, ma'am.
Okay, so here's your question. In the world of pageantry, there has been a lot of stereotyping that says it is a bit feministic kind of thing. As an aspiring Mr. B said, how are you going to break that long-issued stereotype and encourage them to join?
Thank you for that wonderful question, ma'am. Good evening, everyone. So, as an aspiring PBCC, Mr. PBCC, I am the one who will be breaking that stereotype because I am also not a good-looking and a masculine man, just like the pageant stereotype of the pageant, male pageant. So I will encourage them to man up and showcase their talent, because pageant is not just for a masculine man or a pale white skin, but it is also for those people who want to showcase their talent and boost their self-confidence. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, candidate number two. So the candidate number two emphasizes and tells us that we should embrace our flaws. Okay, let us proceed for the candidate number three. Okay, your lucky judge will be judge number three.
Okay, so here's your question. According to Aristotle, educating the mind without educating the heart is no education at all. As you took the path of early childhood education, where you will be dealing with young learners in the future, thus disciplining the student's part of educating the heart.
In this world where everything is very influential, it is very vital for our students, especially the young minds, to be molded. Educating the minds is not just the basis of intellectual and achievements or success, but rather, educating the heart is very important so that they couldn't forget the human actions and the humankind. That we need to inflect the world full of positivity. We, as future educators, is a leader, leading the students into the brighter tomorrow, a paradigm of hope, and of course, bringing the burning torch, illuminating the lives of many children. In that way, we can inflect the world full of positivity, success, because we touch the golden points of each heart of human. What we aim in this early childhood education is to mold the future buds of hope, to be able to conquer the adversities that we are now experiencing today. Because we aim for a better world, a better haven to live on. Thank you and good evening.
Hi sir, how's your Q&A experience?
Wala, grabe ka. Hello. Grabe ka, hello. First time ito na ko night up. First time na ko naka-experience ito. Q&A. Sa lakad kay tao. So, tarata. Wala na express rin. So, idea.
You did your
sayang.
Best. Wow. For the next time naman.
First of last.